Joining me now is Indiana Congressman Jim Banks, Republican Study Committee Chair. Congressman, from telework to proxy voting, this has to end at the federal level. I mean, you guys can just stay at home and, you know, vote in your pajamas, I guess, still, according to Nancy Pelosi. Your response to all this?
Well, Laura, it's infuriating. I mean, when you consider that right now we have a backlog of 182,000 claims at the VA for our veterans, who, by the way, are calling my office every day. They're frustrated with the bureaucracy. And this that backlog, by the way, is caused specifically because the VA employees are working from home. You have Social Security offices all over the country that have closed. You have to do everything by mail with Social Security because workers are working from home. You have a 12 to 18 week backlog for visa applications at the State Department because of this mess. And you could go on and on, more examples of this. Like I have constituents who are calling my office and saying they still haven't received their 2020 tax return from the IRS because of this issue. It's really at the end of the day, it's a matter of fairness. My brother works in the same factory my dad worked at. He goes to work every day and makes axles. He can't work from home, but he does pay taxes, and his tax dollars are going to pay for federal government employees who are making twice as much money. They get twice as many vacation days. It's not public service if you're better off than everyone else around you. That's what we call a scam.
Yeah, well, they all have to either come back to work or they're non-essential and they should gradually just be phased out of the federal workforce. Don't you agree? I mean, if you can't drag yourself into the workplace, but you expect the Amazon delivery guy to come to you every day, how is this right or fair to the American taxpayer?
Yeah, it's not fair at all. But to your point earlier, Laura, the example is being set by Democrats in Congress who just released the new congressional schedule for 2022 today, just earlier today. And we will be in session fewer days next year than what we were in session this year, the least amount of days that members of Congress will actually go to work in modern history. Yet every member of Congress will still get a paycheck for $174,000 a year. They can vote by proxy. They never have to come to Washington, D.C.
This
is the Democrat example that they've set for the American people, and they're playing it out with federal employees as well.
I honestly think, Congressman, most people in real America, they don't know this is happening, but I'm telling you, you drive by HHS or the transportation, these huge hulking office buildings in D.C., I'd say about a third of the lights are on, or the third of the offices seem like they're occupied, which leads to the next question. How many of these employees did we ever need in the federal government, and why are they still working? Because they're not really working. That's the answer.
It proves that point. It proves it very, very well. And when we get the majority back in the next election, Laura, hold us accountable for this.
Oh, we will.
We have to dig into this to look at how many federal government employees do we really need? I mean, actually study each department by department and determine how many of these employees can be cut. Because the hardworking American people who do have to go to a job every day, who actually do something, they actually work and create something, they're the ones who are footing the bill for those who aren't doing it, who have a job where they can stay at home and still get paid $100,000 or more. Take this example into account. At the Department of Education, the Federal Department of Education, they on average make $100,000 a year. Teachers make half of that on average around the country. And these federal employees who work at the Department of Education, they don't teach kids how to read or write, and they're making twice as much as teachers. Now they get to stay home and to do their job, do whatever job it is that they do from home.
Now, well, I used to work at the Department of Education many moons ago, and transportation. I wondered what half the people in the building were ever doing. Congressman, we will hold your feet to the fire when you take back the majority. Thank you.